Hi everyone, Chef Mark here, and I'm at Appliance Factory in Mattress Kingdom to talk to you about how to use a whisk. And specifically, we're gonna be whipping some cream. So I teach cooking classes in people's homes, and I hear this debate as to when you use a whisk, do you use it in a circular motion or a back and forth motion? So I'm here to offer you my opinion based on what I see when I'm in people's homes, and plus my 30 years of experience. Before I get started, what I want you to do is click the subscribe button. Oh, wait. Awesome. Thanks. Appreciate that. All right, let's get to work. Heavy cream. Buy heavy cream. And be careful. So you want the highest percentage fat possible. I always look for heavy cream. If it just says whipping cream, in my experience, it doesn't have enough fat to actually whip in the cream. I know, it's silly, but I think that whipping cream isn't good for whipping cream. I think it's heavy cream that you want. I'm just gonna do a small amount here. Now, if I were making this for dessert, I would add some powdered sugar and maybe some vanilla extract. Okay, here we go. So I am of the opinion that you wanna go back and forth as opposed to in a circle. And the reason I don't like a circle is because see how half the time my whisk isn't touching anything? Whereas if you go back and forth, you're really getting the most kind of penetration from your whisk. And really what we're doing is aerating the cream. We want to pump air into it. Okay, so here we go. Now you can see I'm spinning the bowl, and sometimes I'm going in a circle and sometimes I'm going back and forth. And there's two reasons for that. One, when I go in a circle, I'm just giving my arm a little bit of a break. But I'm also making sure that I'm bringing fresh cream. So if I just do this the whole time, you can see I might only be whipping this spot right here and not being very even. And you want to be vigorous. So this is okay, but this is better. Okay. Now, another thing I like to do is adjust from palm down to palm up. And that will use kind of a different part of your structure here, your muscles. So I like to hold it kind of like a pencil, and I just have it bounce around. So I'm kind of doing this sweeping motion here, but what I'm really doing is letting the bowl do the work. I'm pushing out, the whisk is kind of bouncing back on its own. Okay, my arm's getting tired, so I'm gonna switch. What I'd like to do is back and forth a few times, and then just kind of push and spin. We're starting to get ribboning. So when I run my whisk through, you can see it leaves some streaks where the whisk once was, and that's the ribbons. And that tells me that I'm getting there. I'm at least halfway. So I'm right-handed, so I'm not as comfortable doing this left hand, but here's my right hand, a little bit of a break. And the best part to do if you're, the best thing to do if you're making whipped cream with a bunch of people, just switch out, just pan the bowl around and you'll get it back, and then it'll be whipped cream. All right, we're getting close. You can see I'm not too concerned with making a mess when I'm making whipped cream. I'm gonna clean up afterwards. That's why I'm wearing an apron, to keep the cream from getting on my shirt. All right, look at that, we're almost there. Another thing I can do to reduce this mess that I'm making, it's everywhere, is just to use a larger bowl. Now, for those of you that insist on using KitchenAid mixer or a hand mixer, careful, because it's easy to whip it so quickly by machine that it starts to fall instantly. It's like a balloon, and if you fill that balloon slowly, it will be more thoroughly mixed and it won't lose its wit as quickly. So if you're gonna do it with a machine, it works great, but don't crank it on to 10, just a medium speed, and just let it go for a longer amount of time. And you'll find that your whipped cream will hold up for a longer time before it starts to deflate and kind of turn back into liquid. All right, here we go, we're almost in. And that's part of the reason why I prefer to do it by hand. If I'm sweetening this for dessert, I like to use powdered sugar. The powdered sugar will, it's loftier, it won't weigh things down. And I add that at the beginning, it actually aids in the whipping and it whips a little bit quicker. Vanilla, I'll add at the beginning, but if I'm adding something like Frangelico, Grand Marnier, something like that, I add that at the end to adjust how thick it is. All right. And how do you know when your whipped cream is perfect? Well, here's how you tell. You test it by holding it upside down over your head. That is the only way to know if your whipped cream is perfectly combined. Here we go. So there's some tips and tricks on how to use a whisk and how to make whipped cream. Try it by hand. And it's a great thing to do if you have a bunch of friends and family around. Maybe it's the holidays and people are waiting for dessert, coffee to brew or something. Pull out a bowl, pull out a whisk and some cream, some powdered sugar, maybe some vanilla, and just hand it around and enjoy the magic of making whipped cream. One thing though, be careful you don't over whip it, because then you end up with butter. And we all love butter, but when we're looking for whipped cream and we end up with butter, sad face. All right, everyone, Chef Mark with Appliance Factory in Mattress Kingdom. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and I'll see you next time.